Hello students, today I am going to tell you about lesson number 4. I am going to explain lesson 4, that is formatting in Microsoft Word 2010. Microsoft Word already you have learned. What is this Microsoft Word? Microsoft Word is a word processing software. This already you know. And this Microsoft Word is developed by Microsoft company. Okay, Microsoft is a company. And it is a part of Microsoft Office. This Microsoft company develops this Microsoft Word. And Microsoft Word is known as word processing software. Means you can do typing, editing, printing, anything in this Microsoft Word. Now today I will tell you formatting in Microsoft Word. This is given in your chapter. Formatting. Formatting means changing appearance. Changing appearance. Appearance means the look of anything. Okay? Changing the appearance, like you have written a paragraph, you are changing the color of that paragraph. Okay? Changing the style, changing the size of that paragraph, size of the font, applying different effects. That is known as formatting. Okay? So formatting means changing appearance. How you do that, that you will learn in this chapter. Now see, first topic which is given, that I am going to tell you, that is Format Painter. Now first I am going to tell you about this Format Painter. This Format Painter button is present on Home tab. Okay, this Format Painter button is present on Home tab, and this Format Painter button is of this brush shape, like this. Brush shape button is there, okay, on the Home tab. That is known as Format Painter tool or Format Painter button. Now what is the work of this Format Painter button? Suppose you have written something in Microsoft Word, like I am writing here, like I have written one sentence in Microsoft Word, like I am writing this in like this. Okay, this sentence you have written in Microsoft Word, and this you have written in a very beautiful style, font style you have chosen. Color also you have changed. Okay, you have made it bold, underline, everything you have done in this. Okay, this you have written, and so many effects you have applied on this line in Microsoft Word. And you have written another line. Okay, another line you have written. This is next line which you have written, and this line is without any effect. This is very simple, and this line you have applied so many effects, colors, style, everything you have changed in this text, and this is very simple. Now what you want? You want to copy the same style of this line as it is into this line. Same style, same effect, same formatting you want to copy as given in this line to this line. So for that we use Format Painter tool. Format Painter copies the style or effect of text to another text. Now how will you do? Whose effect you want to copy? Like you want to copy the effect of this line. So what you will do? You will select this line. Then you will click on Format Painter tool. As soon as you will click on Format Painter tool, Format Painter tool will change into a brush shape. When it will change into a brush shape, then you will click where you want to copy. Like I want to copy here. So you will click on this, and you will see that this text will also have the same appearance as this one. So this is the work of Format Painter tool. So this was about Format Painter. What is the work of Format Painter? It's very simple. It copies the style and effect of one text into another text. For that, this Format Painter is used. So what is Format Painter? Format Painter is simply an option or button in MS Word using which we can copy the style of one text to another text. Now next topic which is given in your book, that I am going to explain, that is subscript and superscript. Now see, this superscript and subscript, these two buttons are there in MS Word. And these both buttons are present on Home tab. Both buttons are present on this Home tab. Both buttons you will get on Home tab. Okay, now what is this superscript? Super already means above. Meaning of super means above. Sub means below. Meaning of sub means below. Now what is this superscript? Suppose you might have seen sometimes that sometimes when you see some text is written like this. Like I am writing a letter here and you see like this. Square you might have seen like this text is written. Or something is written like this. Okay, and one text is written like this on the top. So, what is the work of superscript? Superscript makes your text smaller than the normal text and place it above the normal line. Okay, this is your normal line. This is your normal line. And when you will apply superscript, what it will do? It will make the text small and it will write here, upside, like this. Okay, if you want to write like this, so for that we use this superscript. Now what this subscript do? This is opposite of this. Subscript makes the text smaller and write it below the normal line. Okay, you might have seen these formulas in chemistry. Okay, so to write these formulas in MS Word, we use this subscript. Suppose we write first H and now we want to write 2. So what you will do? You will click on subscript button and then you will click on 2. So you will see this 2 will come downside in small size. That is known as subscript. So superscript makes your text smaller and write it above the normal text. And subscript makes your text smaller and write it below the normal text. Anything. It is not only number, alphabets, letters, symbols, anything you can write. Okay. Superscript means above the normal line. And subscript means below the normal line. So this was about superscript and subscript. Now next topic which is given in your book, that is applying shadow effect. Now what is this shadow effect? This shadow effect, whatever you are writing, suppose I am writing a word, okay, if you want to apply a shadow to this word, like this shadow, okay, like shadow effects you want to apply to this word, so you can click on this shadow effect button. One, like this shadow effect button is there, capital A is written on that, and this button also you will get on the home tab. This shadow effect button is there, which is present on the home tab. Okay, on home tab you will get this shadow effect button. What you have to do? Simply you have to select the text where you want to apply this shadow. Like you want to apply in whole line, select that line, click on this shadow effect button and you will see your line will have shadow effect appearance. So in this way you can apply shadow to your text. This is known as shadow effect in MS Word. Now next topic, that is applying header and footer. This is also very good feature in MS Word, header and footer. Now what is header? Header already you know, head. Head means top part. Footer means foot. Foot means bottom part. Header means upper part, top part of a page, and footer means bottom part, lower part of the page. Suppose this is your page. And if you want to write any information on the top of the page, so you have to click on header option. If you want to write any information on the bottom of the page, so you will choose footer option. Two options are there in MS Word, header and footer. Now what is this header and footer? These two options you will get on insert tab. One insert tab is there, here home tab only, insert tab is there. You will click on this insert tab, you will get these two options, header and footer option. Now what is the work of this header and footer option? Sometimes you might have seen that in a book, there are so many pages and what you see the page number on the bottom of every page of your book. Or sometimes the chapter name is given on every page of this book. So if you want to write the information like that in MS Word, you can use this footer option. Or sometimes you want to write date on every page, so you can use header option. Suppose you are having 1000 pages and you want to write this date on that 1000 pages. You want the date should appear on top of every page and there are 1000 pages. So what you do, you click on header, you apply header on first page, write the date, and automatically you will see this header will be applied on all the pages. So using this header, you can write any information on top of the page, and using footer, you can write any information on bottom of the page so that it will appear on every page, not only in one page. How many pages are there, that information will appear on every page. Header means top, footer means bottom. So this was all about today. Next topic, I will explain you on next term. If you have any problem, you can contact me. And please like and subscribe my channel, Wings Tuition Classes. Thank you.